Double Sports Talk, worldwide, with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now, it's getting interesting. You know what I knew. Rocky Marciano Jr., he said he don't think that this fight with Conor McGregor should give Floyd Mayweather that 50-0, breaking his father's record. Right? Some agree, some disagree. Would it be 49, you know, 49 going up to 50 and breaking the record with a guy coming from MMA? Would that count as number 50? You know, so, you know, you could be on both sides of the fence on this one, right? But I'm on the other side. I don't know which side you on, but I think that it should be 50. I think it should be 50. Because it would definitely be 49-1 if he lost. If we could all, right now, categorize and say categorically that if Floyd Mayweather loses this fight, it don't count as 49-1. If we can all say that now, then okay. But that ain't what we're going to say. If he loses, it's 49-1. So if the man wins, it's 50-0. Because even Rocky Marciano, you know, it's documented. His first 20 fights weren't against world beaters. You got a few McGregors in there, people of lesser quality than McGregor in there. A few. Mayweather been fighting top quality opponents since his about 13, 14 fight. Top quality, and we all know it. So he has to be held of a standard of, hey, I'm a mortal. I can fight, you know, great guys, but not always, just like everybody else. Because let's be real about Floyd Mayweather, how we rate him, right? Andre Berto is a two-time world champion. Floyd Mayweather, on his very last fight, old dude, just trying to get up out of here to fulfill his contract, leaving. He can't fight a two-time world champion. We want to boycott that. Andre Berto, you know, top fit dude, stamina, a lot of power, a lot of resilience. Don't let himself get knocked out. We've seen him, you know, come in a fight with one arm, fighting to the end, right? That speed, all that stuff. It don't count against Mayweather, right? No, Mayweather, you can't fight him. But if we mention who are the four baddest dudes in welterweight, you probably say, well, you know, hey, man, y'all, everybody got to watch out for Errol Spence. Then you got, hey, whoa, Keith Thurman, he got the title, so what's up? Danny Garcia barely lost to Keith Thurman. Sean Porter can get with any of them. You know, then you stop there, and then there's a few guys still out here probably start saying about Amir Khan, but I hope there's not many of you left, right? But, you know, those are the four names that's going to really hit you because Kell Brook just lost, and he's really, really got eye socket problems right now. So we don't know what's going to happen with him. He's probably going to leave the division. So those are probably the four baddest dudes you're mentioning right now. You're not really saying Pacquiao and Jeff Horn right now when you're talking the four baddest. But, okay, put Pacquiao in there, right? But here's the deal. Andre Berto versus any of those, right? We just saw Porter, one of the baddest dudes. Can't nobody push him around. Porter's coming forward. We were excited about Porter against Berto, right? But we can't, old Floyd Mayweather leaving, he can't fight him. So we're not going to do that. Conor McGregor, the fight will count. You got in the ring, you're getting paid $100 million. You know, hey, the fight's going to count, period. And matter of fact, it's not like it's an active young Floyd Mayweather. Been out 2 years, man, 40 years old. Let him have a soft touch if this is what this is. Because see, Conor McGregor ain't coming here to be soft touching nobody. We know that. So let's see what happens. But if you ask me, yes, it should be 50-0 because it would definitely be 49-1. Dome Sports Talk, worldwide. And I'm up out of here, y'all.